urethral injury. Causes of urethral injury usually caused by crushing force to the pelvis. It's about 4 to 14% of patients with pelvic fracture. Clinical features: blood at the external urethral meatus, high riding prostate, inability to pass urethral catheter, complication stricture, impotence, urinary incontinence. Type of urethral injury: type 1, posterior urethra stretched but intact. Type 2, urethra disrupted at the membranoprostatic junction above the urogenital diaphragm. Type 3, membranous urethra disrupted with extension to the proximal pulbus urethra or disruption of urogenital diaphragm, most common type. Type 4, bladder neck injury with extension into the urethra. Type 4A, injury of the base of the bladder with and periurethral extravasation, simulating a true type 4 urethral injury. Type 5, partial or complete pure anterior urethral injury. Radiological examination: dynamic retrograde urethrography, pericatheter urethrogram, MRI, ultrasound. MRI, planning surgical approach for posterior urethral disruption, define damage to soft tissue adjacent to urethral trauma. Ultrasound, define hematoma size and extension of extravasation, not used for primary diagnosis. As we found, this is type 1 urethral injury, rupture of pubo-prostatic ligament, cranial displacement of the prostate, elongation of the posterior urethra, elevated bladder, no urethral rupture, no extravasated dye, no contrast media extravasation, rupture of pubo-prostatic ligament, cranial displacement of the prostate, elongation of posterior urethra. This retrograde urethrogram reveals stretching of the posterior urethra as we see. Type 2 injury, torn of membranous urethra above intact urogenital diaphragm. We found a retrograde urethrogram, contrast media extravasation above cone-shaped proximal portion of bulbous urethra. Proximal portion of bulbous urethra, extravasated contrast material. Contrast material vasation confined to area above normal cone-shaped proximal portion of bulbous urethra. Type 3 injury, urethral injury, most common form of urethral injury. Membranous urethra is disrupted with extension of injury into proximal bulbous urethra through disruption of urogenital diaphragm. Extravasation at the membranous and bulbous urethra. This membranous urethra, as we see, and this bulbous urethra, we found extravasation at both membranous and bulbous urethra. We found this is type 3 injury, urethral injury. This is urogenital diaphragm, which is disrupted. Type 4 bladder neck injury. And we found this is bladder neck injury with extension into urethra. Extravasated contrast, as we see, this membranous urethra, bulbous urethra, urogenital diaphragm. Type 5 injury of bulbous urethra. Intact pux fascia, the dissection of urine, blood along benign shift. Dissection of blood urine along benign shift. Rupture pux fascia, extravasation into peroneum. This is type 5 injury of bulbous urethra. This bulbous urethra injury, either intact pux fascia or rupture pux fascia, which give extravasation into perineum. Posterior urethral rupture extending through urogenital diaphragm to involve bulbous urethra following plant trauma. Type 3 urethral injury. Type 3 urethral injury. retrograde urethrogram refill contrast material extravasation at the membranous urethra contrast material extend below unogenital diaphragm surround proximal bulbous urethra surround proximal bulbous urethra. This is bladder neck injury type 4, 23 year old woman. We found extra peritoneal contrast material extravasation that extends from bladder neck to the left underneath balloon of fullness of catheter. And cystogram obtained 2 minutes show progressive extra peritoneal contrast material extravasations. Retrograde urethrogram interpretation. Either partial urethral tear or complete tear. We found contrast extravasation and contrast in the bladder partial tear. We found contrast extravasation only complete tear. This partial tear. Extravasation of contrast and contrast in the urinary bladder. This partial urethral tear. Complete tear we found extravasation contrast only. No contrast urinary bladder is complete tear. Total urethral disruption, complete tear. Anterior urethra, more common than posterior, either by direct trauma, no pelvic fracture, blood at meatus, unable to micturate, benign scrotal peroneal contusion, hematoma, fluid collection may be present. CT signs of urethral injury. CT signs of urethral injury. In type 1 urethral injury, elevation of prostatic apex above urogenital diaphragm, elevation of prostatic apex, associated finding includes distortion of prostatic contour and obscurations of the periprostatic fat space by hematoma. Distortion of prostatic contour and obscurations of pre-prostatic fat space by hematoma. Type 2 injury in CT. CT criteria specific for type 2 included extravasations of urinary tract contrast material that's found above urogenital diaphragm. As we see in this CT. Type 2 injury, and this is retrograde urethrogram. Type 3 injury, CT scan obtained at perineal regions show extravasated contrast material in the urinary tract below urogenital diaphragm. Here, for retrograde urethrogram, extravasated contrast material in the urinary tract at the level of the urogenital diaphragm, type 3 injury. Indicators for urethral injury that are non-type specific. Distortion or obscuration of the urogenital diaphragm fat brain. Distortion obscuration urogenital diaphragm fat brain. CT scan obtained type 2 urethral injury. The partial absence of the left urogenital diaphragm fat brain. Normal right one. Hematoma of the ischiocavernous muscle. Hematoma of ischiocavernous muscle as we see in type 2 urethral injury. Fracture left ischiopubic ramus with hematoma of the ischiocavernous muscle. And abscess of adjacent fat brain. We found that these sections above previous section arterial extravasations of the material. Distortion or obscuration of prostatic contour. This is found in this patient with type 1 urethral injury. Absence of normal prostatic outline, periprostatic hematoma obliterates fat brain. Distortion obscuration of the bulbocavernous muscle. Distortion obscuration bulbocavernous muscle. Patient obtained with type 3 urethral injury show distorted contour of the bulbocavernous muscle with obscured fat brain. Hematoma of the obturator internus muscle. And this patient with retrograde cystogram profiled type 2 urethral injury found in CT extensive hematoma of the obturator internus